high school, or, you know, from then on up. And everything they did, that they were like my leaders. They were my, you know, the guys that I looked up to. What they were involved with was like drinking, partying. You know, I don't necessarily know if they did drugs, but like smoking cigarettes and all that. And that's what I thought was cool. You know, I thought that was like the end thing. Something, that's the thing that, you know, oh, they're doing it. That's who I want to follow. Like, it would be so cool. Everyone's going to look up to me. That's what I'm going to look forward to, that being that popular kid. And, you know, everyone knows that, you know, I go out and make a fool of myself sometimes, or, you know, I get drunk or whatever. So back then, like, that's what I went through junior college, too. And throughout the whole divorce thing, I had a lot of problems, like insecurities just with, okay, my family broke up and we weren't very close. And so the way I dealt with those problems was to, you know, go out and drink and shove those problems down and not speak to anyone about it. And that was definitely the wrong way. I mean, back then, like, I wish I would have changed it and had a leader that would have, you know, inspired me, encouraged me to get to the Word, would, you know, would have led me to know who Jesus Christ was back then. Instead, I, you know, I drank, I hid my problems, and I ruined a lot of friendships, a lot of relationships. I had problems with my family as well. In my junior college, my sophomore year of college, got real heavy into smoking marijuana. That was another scapegoat that I used. A lot of things were going very well in baseball, and at that same time, I still didn't know the Lord. Like, I knew God existed. That's basically all I knew. I really wasn't interested in getting involved with that. So a lot of different things happened. I played, you know, I wasn't playing up to my potential. Had some friends that weren't encouraging me to, you know, weren't teaching me who Christ was, weren't teaching me to go to church, telling me to go to church. So smoking, drinking, all that was my way of life, and that really ruined a lot of things. I'm behind in school because of those days. I mean, I had dropped classes, had oral grades in junior college, that's all I did. Just didn't care. Smoking, that was one thing. I'd come home and that was relieving. All the pain was gone through that for just that temporary time. And I wish I had that person in my life that would have pushed me a different way and said, hey, Todd, like, look where your life is going. Look what you're doing in class. Look where your athletics are going. You know, you're losing your drive to succeed and what you want to do in your life. Slowly, like, being diminished by all that stuff. It wasn't until I came out of APU and I got around people that had that strong faith and pushed me forward, and that's how I got out of all that. So I encourage you guys to stay away from that.